coming up this Friday night. We've been talking about it. It is the second annual Maine General Dance for Hospice going on at the Calumet Club in Augusta. And we have a couple of people with us this morning, the first of whom we're going to talk to about Hospice, Maine General Hospice. Terry Petrulis is here. You are the community and facility liaison for this area, the Augusta Gardner area. And tell us what Maine General Hospice does, who you serve. And it's more people than I thought you served.
We serve the entire Maine General Hospice serves from Skowhegan area down to the Gardner area. There's three different offices, one in Waterville, Skowhegan, and Gardner, and I'm in the Gardner office. And we serve people in their homes and help families care for their patient at home. But we also serve people in facilities, so whether it's nursing homes or residential care facilities, we're able to come in and help them in those facilities too. So it's wherever their home is where we take care of them.
And, of course, hospice is not it's for the the person who is dying, but it's also for the family that is there, you know, going through this process with them.
Correct. We are there to care for the patient and the family as a unit. So the family often needs more care than the patient does as far as emotional support. And we offer bereavement services for up to 13 months after someone dies to the family.
Yeah. And it's an amazing organization. It really is. You guys do stupendous work. And we had firsthand experience when my mother-in-law passed away a year ago last August, right, Marianne?
Yeah, it'll be 2 years in August already.
Wow. Now, Marianne, of course, my wife, she's the one that she's worked tirelessly, not just the first time around, which was last year, the first one. You think, well, that's always the toughest one. They just happen after that. Not so much. She's been working nonstop getting this dance ready to go for Friday night, tomorrow night. And tell us, it's going to be at the Calumet Club, and what do we have going on there?
Yeah, it's 7 to 8 is social hour, where we'll be selling lots of raffle tickets for different things. Dancing 8 to midnight at Le Club Calumet.
Le Club.
Like John said, it's our second one, and, you know, you got to pay it forward, and you got to give back.
Thank you.
Mm. You know, again, like John said, my mother was diagnosed in 2012 with pancreatic cancer the day before Thanksgiving, and she died the following August. And though myself, I have a sister who's a nurse, you know, two nieces that are nurses, and you think you got that nurse hat on and you're going to take care of all this, but your kids first and daughters first. You know, and what I like to add about death and dying is I've always believed that people celebrate birth, they have baby showers, and they celebrate it, but they're afraid of death. But, you know, we're all going to take that door sooner or later. So once the doctor decides or the patient decides they've had enough, no more treatment, just put it on cruise control, join hands, and just enjoy the journey.
Mm. And that's what hospice helps you do.
Right.
And so hopefully we're going to raise some money for this tomorrow. And you're funded basically by outside sources, right?
Well, no, we are funded by Medicare, Maine Care, and other insurance companies.
Yep.
But there are some people who don't have any insurance, and then we end up having to use United Way funds or donations.
Right.
We also provide extra things that some hospices don't provide, like massage therapy, music and art therapy, and our volunteers. And we have to pay for all of those through donations and through United Way, things like that.
Oh, that's awesome. That's really neat. Now, what are we going to, we're going to have prizes. We're going to have fun tomorrow night. It's
going to
be fun.
Oh, we are. You know, first of all, I'd like to thank Roger Pomelo and the Augusta Marketplace for sponsoring this.
Yep.
We have Rooster's gift cards. We have gift cards from Red Barn, Cabela's, Don Plourd, Caldwell Banker Real Estate in Waterville donated four Sea Dogs tickets.
Box seat tickets. Nice tickets.
You know, and I have siblings that have bought different things to donate for raffles. So, last year we had a blast. The place was packed.
And Marianne, by the way, has put her heart and soul into a quilt. Well, you have. Well, I know you didn't want... Yeah, you have. I mean, this is what I'm talking about. You worked tirelessly on that thing. It's big. It's huge. It's beautiful.
Well, you know, it's what I like to do.
I know.
Yeah. We really appreciate it.
You're very welcome.
So there you go. Yeah. Marianne, thank you. Marianne and Terry, thank you very much.
Yeah, thanks for the airtime.
You bet. And it's tomorrow night, the happy hour. I say happy hour. It's social hours from 7 to 8. And dance starts at 8. Matt James, our son, will be there. It's going to be kind of like a family affair, I think.
And well, you know what? That's what it's turned into.
Yeah.
You know, from last year to this year, there's a lot of family involvement.
So that's a good thing. That's great. and the memories. The gift keeps on giving, and it's in memory, technically in memory of Muriel Turgeon.
Yes, it is. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. We appreciate it.